Welcome back to Graveyard Keeper. Some pretty obvious stuff to do today. Need to get her some jewelry. That is not going to happen right now. Hell shit. Y'all may have noticed this little windmill thing I got going over there. That's my water pump. You need water for beer, you need it for mead, you need it for juice. Well, not juice, but you need it for a lot of stuff. So I made a water pump. All right, I need to go and talk to the Inquisitor today, because he's supposed to tell me something for the bishop. I need his endorsement for something. I don't remember what it was. The bishop, something like bishop needs an endorsement for me to join him at a thing. Dark, dark days for humankind. I have two pieces of news for you. One bad, one good. First, the bad news. I'm sorry to say it, but there's a chance our king is possessed. He's been talking too much recently about humanity and human rights. I had an audience with him, and he told that it's not okay to just grab people without any evidence and burn them alive. So we need to put our little burning on pause until we bring him some evidence. But here's the good news. I know where we can get this evidence. Not long ago, we were interrogating a witch. She swore up and down that she was innocent, but just after her death, a big ghost that looked like a chicken with red eyes appeared above her. And it told us that all our cruelty and injustice to the innocent had awakened an ancient curse, that soon our dead would arise and seek revenge. Sounds like witchcraft to me. We decide to ask someone from the university about this ancient curse. We had one of them in the next cell over, in fact. He told us that once a terrible curse was laid upon the town, and it was quieted by an ancient contract. First sign of the curse's return should be dark magic organs inside corpses. We'll need to gather them. A dark heart, dark brain, and a dark intestine. Find them in corpses and bring them to me as evidence of witchcraft for the king. Here are some old notes. Maybe they'll help you. Oh, shit. Okay. About the ceremony at my cathedral. Monsignor, can I ask you a favor?
I'm listening.
Could you attend a big ceremony at my new cathedral? Together with Bishop, we'll pray for water to return to the town.
Meh, I have no time for such nonsense.
We need someone important to attend.
Try to find someone from the royal court.
All right, need to talk to my buddy the astrologer again. Tell him that Miss Charm needs help. I think I've found a way you can earn your daughter's forgiveness. What can I do? I'm ready to do anything within my power and beyond. There's one young man. Well, right now he's not exactly a man. Long story short, he's in danger. He's been imprisoned at the mountain fort. Your daughter wants to save him.
Why?
Well, she said that she loves him, so if you help her release him, it would be good first step.
Interesting. The fort is closed and strictly guarded. I've been there once at an archaeological exposition. It didn't end well. We accidentally blew up the northern pass. It wasn't our fault. The great blast interfered with our calculations. The Lord Commander threatened to kill me. We barely made it out alive. But many years have passed. I think we could arrange a new expedition by order of the university. And then we might covertly release this young man.
About the expedition. How are we going to arrange it? You don't even work there anymore.
Meh. We're members of the inner circle. Lovers' quarrels are easy to mend. I just need to show them that I've made progress in my studies and I'm in again.
Have you made any progress?
Not really. I feel so empty inside, and now I can't think of anything besides my daughter. You need to help me. You You're a smart young man. Do you know how to write?
Yeah.
Write a book. It shouldn't be too bad. But write whatever you want. With my esteemed name on a cover, it should do well.
Oh, crap.
Okay, well, I need a book then. Alright, it's said to do a silver star book. I think I can do that now and bring it back to him. Pretty sure I can do that. A gold star book. Oh, man. You know, I'm going to have to make a silver star one anyway, because I don't know if that'll work. If nothing else, I can just sell the thing, but... Crap. Ah, crap. I don't have the right stuff for it now. Damn. I guess I'm going to have to go back to him anyway. I might have to buy a hardcover, because I can't make one right now. Got here in time, and... No, I can't sell him. I can't use the gold star one. I'm going to have to use a silver star one. Crap. Okay. I can sell him that gold star book. Yeah, I'll sell him that. Since I need dark body parts, I'm going to have to get more carrots. I grew so many of the damn things, I just got a box of them sitting over here. I'm just going to take 50. That'll give me plenty of bodies.
You know what? I kind of like you. You're my only friend.
You're my friend, too.
I hope you never get home, and one day you'll be a skull just like me. And the new guy will dig us both out. That would be so much nicer, sitting here together.
Sounds good, but I do need to get home.
Yeah, sure. It's just an old skull's dream.
That's an interesting interaction there, buddy. There's a gnat in my office. I think that audio capture got picked up. Making this jewelry stuff takes a long time, obviously. I'm just working on one little thing, but it's time consuming. Jewelry goes fast, I guess. But gold jewelry details. Yeah, details. It makes a lot of sense. Finally. Took me 3 bodies to find 1 dark body part. Alright, I'm back and I got your damn book. Here's the book. Here's what I wrote.
Nice title page. Okay, come by next week and I'll tell you what happened.
You suck. It's gonna be torture waiting an entire week, letting everything run by when I've already got so much done, tempted to leave in every bit of footage between him saying that and you getting to watch it. But I don't hate you. I hate myself enough to wait that long, but... You're nice people. Since I basically missed making the jewelry by like a few hours, I had to wait a whole week to come back. Here's some jewelry. Well, that looks nice. That design is so fresh. I can definitely sell a lot of them to the noble ladies in the town. What about promoting my company? Sure, I'll tell everyone about your vegetables too. Oh, and now she sells jewelry and perfume. I don't need either of those right now. So I'm going to leave it alone. I realized that in asking me for a dark heart, he was asking me for more than one thing. Snake was only asking me for the one. So I've got a dark heart for him, and that puts me up to 100.
Cutscene. At last, everything's ready. Just a second. Wait here. I need to gather my followers.
How long do I need to wait?
Sorry. At
least an hour, maybe two. Jerry, is that you?
What a stupid question. Of course it's me. I wouldn't miss this ceremony for the world. Should be hilarious.
Do you know what Snake's gonna summon?
Sod, yes.
Actually, as his inner voice, I know who he would like to summon. But I have another guess about who he's actually going to get, and I can't wait to see. So let's wait. All right. Tick-tock, tick-tock, buddy.
Today's the day. Today I get what I have wanted for my entire life. A curse, all of them, all of my anger, I sacrifice it for you. Appear among us, I beg you. Father.
What?
Five guardsmen. Wait here, four others. Go.
Son, this is brilliant.
Father? Where? What? Black magic. Now I see it's you. I remember your face. My son is dead. You are a creature of darkness. He was burned with his mother. The house on Witch Hill. Mother threw me out of the window just before the beams collapsed. You wove me a small horse out of vines. I called it Flame.
Son, is that you? Seth, I am your father.
Monsignor, we're here. You disappeared. Grab them, boys.
No, stop. Let them go. Return to headquarters. But,
do it.
Son, it's like a dream.
So can we go too?
Of course go. Just don't ruin the moment.
Yeah, I'd better go too.
Wait, it seems that my ritual was a success after all. Here, my endless notebook is yours. I hope it'll help you get back to your loved one.
Thanks.
And take my eternal burning coal. I don't think I want to burn anybody anymore.
Thank you, Monsignor.
Just call me Edward. What are we going to do about the guardsmen? They saw us.
We need to get back to the town first.
What a twist! But old Jerry knew! York lost the bet!
And I'm one step closer to my love. Now that was interesting. I was gonna push this video out and make it a little bit longer, but that cutscene seemed like a really good place to end it. So I'm gonna end it there, and we'll come back next time for the astrologer and everything. Hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you come back for that one. Bye.